How long does Botox last? Well, it's a complex question. Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me. I'm going through and answering the question, how long does Botox last? It's complex. I'm going to go through seven factors that give you an idea. There's four different neuromodulators or Botox-like products in the United States. In general, think about anywhere from 2.5 to 4 months of duration. But what are those seven factors that make a difference? There's Botox, there's Dysport, there's Xeomin, and now we have Jeuveau. It takes me to the first point, which is, for longevity, the dose. So how much is used? To a certain point, there's a level where more doesn't mean better, but the dose, the more you use, the more longevity, in general, with a few caveats, is what we see. So dose is number one. Number two, individual uniqueness. No one wants to hear it, but definitely at different times of the year, for different individuals and for different people, just like any other drug or product, there's going to be a different effect in the body. And knowing and working with your provider to find the right neuromodulator that works for you, that gives you the longevity and the look that you want, is key. So number two is uniqueness to the individual. Number three is age. No one wants to hear this one either, but the reality is the older we get, the less collagen we have. So if we're losing collagen and the skin is very thin, a little bit of movement returning will create lines. Someone who's younger, that movement doesn't create the lines. So our next factor here is age, and age plays a role in longevity given that factor of collagen and thickness of the skin. Number four is technique. Where the product's placed, how it's used to balance lift and depressors, muscles that lift or depress, how it's placed so that we don't waste the product. For instance, a large forehead, where do we stop? Where's the line where we don't need it? Around the eyes, where are the muscles that are going to affect the smile? Because they come up around the zygomatic bone. So technique and not wasting product, maximizing its usage given the accepted approved doses, will act on longevity as well. So technique, and there's a user dependence there. Number five is self-awareness. Now, what do we mean by that? When people see a little tiny bit of movement, they think, oh my, it's returned, it stopped working. Well, a good treatment reduces muscle activity by 80%, and then slowly over time, the muscle movement tends to want to come back. But if there's 20% of movement left, it's still working very well. But if people see one muscle twitch, sometimes they come back to get more, they think it's not working. If you treat that more, it doesn't mean that that's going to fully go away or freeze the area fully. So it's people's awareness. Conversely, people come back at 1 or 2 years and they'll say, hey, it wore off now. Well, it wore off a year ago. It's just that there was atrophy of that muscle and they liked the way it looked better over the next year, but it didn't last a year, year and a half. We've never seen that type of longevity for this product. Again, it's about 3 to 4 months, but it will be dependent thereon. Number six is skin type. So this leads back to collagen a little bit. Thin, white skin that doesn't have estrogen or hormones, the Botox won't last as long, again, because the little bit of movement will create crinkles, lines, and folds. Darker skin, or skin type 4, 5, and 6, just generally gets less lines. They can be in their 60s and not have a line on their face. So skin type will, in effect, to the user, affect longevity per se. Number seven, last but not least, is commitment to ancillary services. This is your collagen building treatments, microneedling, PlasmaGlo, radio frequency, all those things that you might not see that instant Botox hit of results, but over time makes the skin more robust, stronger, even to where people that do treatments like PlasmaSculpt, Sculptra, collagen building services need less and less neuromodulators over time. They come in to top up on their collagen stimulation as opposed to that quick hit of something that stops the movement, which is your botulinum toxin treatment. So commitment to taking care of your skin. So there's seven factors that affect longevity. Let me know what's your experience with your longevity of your treatment. What's your favorite neuromodulator? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for joining me on this YouTube channel. Join me over on Instagram to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.